Very good evening, one and all present here. So today I'll be discussing about the signal transduction. So what is in this presentation I'll discuss about what is signal transduction, how it involved in the various cellular processes. As we all know that cell is the fundamental unit of all organisms. It was discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665, and cell theory was proposed by Schleiden and Schwann in 1839. According to this theory, all the cells and organelles are surrounded by the membranes. The membranes form the barrier between the inside and outside of the cells. The thickness of the membrane ranges from 50 to 100 angstrom. They are composed of lipids and proteins. The membranes are usually dynamic in nature and they are amphiphilic in nature, which means they have the hydrophilic and hydrophobic components. And usually the membranes are very asymmetric, means the two sides of the membranes, it won't look same. And the membranes are polarized. And the membranes have the special property called selective permeability. It is used in the various cellular processes to conduct the ions or food, whatever is required for the cellular processes. And I'll now discuss about what is cellular homeostasis. Cellular homeostasis, it is the ability or tendency of a cell to maintain internal equilibrium by adjusting its physiological processes. So whether it determines what kind of food enters into the inside of the cells or what to go out from the cells. So this cellular homeostasis process helps to maintain the thermoregulation, osmoregulation, pH, fluid balance and sugar level, etc. And this is the picture of the normal red blood cells. So when we are placed in the high concentrated salt solution, the cells become shrunken. When we place the red blood cells in the very diluted solutions, it becomes swollen and it breaks out. So by when the concentration increases, the level, the size of the blood cells also gets affected. So in order to maintain this concentration level as a normal, so this cellular homeostasis process is used. Next, I'll discuss about what are the components of the cellular membrane. The cell membrane contains a membrane lipids and membrane proteins. Membrane lipids, there are three different types of membrane lipids, namely phospholipids, glycolipids and cholesterol. In the case of membrane proteins, they are defined as the proteins which are bounded in the membrane. There are two different types of membrane proteins. They are integral membrane proteins and the peripheral membrane proteins. In this picture, the green regions are known as the integral membrane proteins. The red regions are known as the peripheral membrane proteins. And you can see the integral membrane and peripheral membrane proteins clearly here. Now I'll discuss about the function of the membrane proteins. We know that proteins are they have different types of functions. And if you see the antibodies, they have similar type of structure and functions. Means they all are Y-shaped, they are dimeric Y-shaped or pentameric Y-shaped antibodies. But all of them are doing the defender mechanism. They are fighting with the invaders. But in the case of enzymes, they have different type of structures, but all of them are doing the catalytic activity or catalytic functions. So, and in the case of membrane proteins, they have different structures as well as the different functions. They have the different structures and different functions. Now I'll discuss in detail about the membrane proteins. The membrane proteins are the key players in the signal transduction. So you can see the different types of membrane proteins here. One is called anchoring proteins and another one is the membrane bound enzymes and other one is the membrane receptors and this is called membrane transporters. And these many different types of membrane proteins are and they have a different type of structures as well. But the receptor proteins are the key players in the signal transduction. Now I'll discuss about what is signal transduction. It is a process in which a biological cell converts one kind of signal or stimulus into another. In this process, a cell or organism senses its environment and reacts accordingly. And this information is from the signal to the stimulus is passed across the plasma membrane, and this process comprises of signaling molecules, transducers, effectors, and so on. And this process helps for the is used for the cell to cell communication, cellular homeostasis, and disease control, and so on. Now I'll discuss about one type of signal transduction is known as the phototransduction. As we all know that we get the food from the plants, the food are getting from the plants are arriving from the photosynthesis process. The photosynthesis process is nothing but the chlorophyll present in the green leaves takes up the light energy and converts into chemical energy. So this is known as phototransduction. One, the light energy is converted into another form of energy. So it is called phototransduction. And similarly, the halobacterium uses the rhodopsin protein for energy production from the light. So it has the rhodopsin protein in the purple membrane patch, and this purple membrane rhodopsins takes up the light and converts the light energy into the chemical energy for the survival of the halobacterium. So with this, I'll stop this presentation. Thank you all for your listening. Thank you.